गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द वेव्स, मैकेनिकल वेव्स. एज वी हैव स्टडीड दैट साउंड इज अ वेव, साउंड ट्रेवल्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वेव्स. ओके, सो यू हैव स्टडीड वेव, यू हैव स्टडीड वेव मोशन. सो यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सम टाइप्स ऑफ वेव्स. ओके, यू विल स्टडी मैकेनिकल वेव्स, वॉट आर इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स, एंड यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टाइप्स ऑफ मैकेनिकल वेव्स. Now, before going to this, I will explain you an experiment activity from your textbook, which will help you to understand easily. Now, see, sound wave needs a medium to travel. As you all have studied, that sound needs a medium to travel, and light don't need any medium to travel. So, from this experiment, you can confirm that sound really needs a medium to travel. Now, you can see here, you will take first electric bell, then you will take a airtight glass bell jar, you will take, okay. Now, what you are going to do, inside the electric bell jar, you will keep the electric bell. Now, you will make the bell to ring, okay. So, inside a jar, what happens, you can hear the ringing of the electric bell. And you are going to study whether the sound, you can hear the sound in the vacuum condition or not. Okay, so slowly you will remove the air from the glass jar, and you can see as the air is removing, as the glass jar is becoming a vacuum, in vacuum condition, so what happens, you can hear the sound which we are hearing before, means which you are hearing in the air medium, it is going to be reduced. Okay, as the air is coming out of the jar, you are hearing the sound, it will stop hearing. Okay, so when the air was there, what happened, that time you are clearly hearing the bell ringing of the bell, of electric bell, and slowly what happened, slowly as we are removing the air, the sound will also reduce. Okay, and when you are removing the complete air from the glass jar, that time you cannot hear the sound. Means what? Now the condition inside the glass jar is vacuum condition. So sound cannot travel through the vacuum condition, and hence you cannot hear the sound. Okay, now we will go, as you, now I have explained you that sound needs a medium. Okay, and how it is, sound is a wave. Which type of wave it is, how it is, that you are going to study here. First, we'll study types of waves, in that mechanical waves and electromagnetic waves. What is the difference between mechanical waves and electromagnetic waves? Okay, in mechanical waves, if any wave need a medium, okay, if any wave needed a medium to move, okay, or for propagation, then such type of wave is called as mechanical wave. Example, a biggest example which we are studying here is sound wave. Okay, sound wave need a medium for transfer or for propagation. Examples, you can see sound wave or wave in a stretched string. If you will take a stretched string, if you will strike it, it will vibrate. Means there also vibrations, how there also waves are produced, and how they are produced along the medium they are producing. So there also the material needs a medium. There also a wave needs a medium to travel. Now here, electromagnetic waves. Okay, what are electromagnetic waves? As it is opposite to the mechanical wave, they don't need any medium to medium for propagation. For example, you have studied about the light waves which don't need any medium for the propagation. Okay, so example of electromagnetic wave is the light waves, also the x-rays, all these are example of electromagnetic waves, as they don't need any medium for propagation. Now we are going to study, as you have understood now, that sound wave is a mechanical wave. Okay, because it needs a medium, sound wave needs a medium for propagation, so it is an example of mechanical wave. So sound wave is a mechanical wave. Now in this you are going to study, mechanical waves are also of two types, that is transverse wave and longitudinal wave. Now from these two types, which one is the sound wave that you are again going to study? Now two types of mechanical wave, transverse wave and longitudinal wave. It is very simple, just you have to consider the movement of vibration, how it vibrates or how the particles move. According to that, the two waves are classified or differentiator. Okay, now in transverse wave, you can see particle do not oscillate along the direction of wave propagation but oscillate up and down. For example, I will give an example so that you can easily understand. Okay, suppose you are taking a wire, stretched string you are taking, and you are vibrating it. Okay, when you are vibrating, how the string will vibrate? It will vibrate up and down. This is the medium. Here the string is attached and you are striking the string. That time you can see the string vibrates up and down. Okay, how it is? It is, you can see here, it oscillates up and down with the mean position. Here this is the mean position and it vibrates up and down. Okay, if it is vibrating, if the particles are oscillating up and down, then such types of waves are called transverse wave. Okay, for example, waves in a stretched string. And second example is, second type is longitudinal wave. Okay, here individual particle of the medium move in a direction parallel to the direction of propagation. Very simple. Here you, as you have studied that when the sound is produced from the source, okay, so that time you can see how the sound travels. It travels like this. Okay, means how it travels? It travels, it hits one air particle, then second, then third, then fourth, then it comes, oscillates also. Okay, here oscillations takes place to and fro. Okay, when the oscillation takes place to and fro, then what happens? It oscillates like this. So at this condition you can see in transverse it was up and down, here it is to and fro. Okay, if any particle or any particle of the medium moves in a direction parallel to the direction of propagation, means propagating, means it is moving this way, and here oscillation is also this way, means both are parallel to each other. Okay, to and fro, medium is like this way and propagation is also this way, both are parallel to each other. So what happens here? It is called as longitudinal wave. Okay, so here one example I have shown you, I have drawn here. If you are taking a spring and if you are stretching it, it comes in a refraction condition. When you are leaving it together, that time what happens? It compresses and it comes in a compression medium. Okay, here also you can see stretching and wind. This way it is. Okay, it is parallel to the propagation, direction of propagation. So here you can see at this condition, the spring is stretched. Okay, stretched means it is rarefaction condition. At this condition you can see it is compressed. So compression, then rarefaction, compression, rarefaction means this way. Okay, so this is an example of longitudinal wave. From these two types now you can understand that how our sound moves. Our sound moves like this way. Okay, our sound moves how? If we are taking a loudspeaker or speaker, when it starts any music, that time you can see the sound waves produce some vibrations, and that vibrations are passed to the air molecules and they start vibrating to and fro in the mean position. If the particle is here, it will start to and fro. Okay, while moving to and fro, what happens? It gives its energy to nearby air particle. Again, suddenly nearby air particle will start vibrating. Like this, it passes the energy or it passes the sound to the listener's ear. Okay, this is the way. So here you can see that sound wave is a longitudinal wave because it passes in such condition. Okay, so this was the different types of waves. So from this, what you have understood? You have understood that sound wave is a mechanical wave and also sound wave is a longitudinal wave. Thank you.